copper. To estimate amount of copper present in a given solution using sodium thiosulfate potentiometrically. In this method, a cell is set up, which consists of calomel as a reference electrode and an oxidation reduction electrode as indicator electrode, which is sensitive to iodide ion concentration. Iodine gets reduced during the course of titration. The change in electrode potential is due to change in activities of iodine, which is in zero oxidation state and then turns into or reduced into iodide ion in the solution. Amount of iodine liberated depends upon the concentration of copper ions present in the solution. The reaction involves iodine on treatment with thiosulfate solution gives iodide ion along with tetrathionate. It is a type of back titration. Apparatus required for the estimation of copper are burette, 100 cm cube volumetric flask, 100 cm cube 2 beakers, stirrer, 10 cm cube graduated pipette. Other requirements are potentiometer, which is calibrated and standardized, calomel electrode, platinum electrode, and KCl salt bridge. Chemicals required for the estimation of copper are saturated KCl solution, copper sulfate pentahydrate solution, 10% Ki solution, glacial acetic acid, and 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate solution, etc. Let's first understand how we are going to perform this experiment. First, you are provided with unknown amount of unknown quantity of copper sulfate solution in a 100 cm cube volumetric flask. You have to dilute the given solution of copper sulfate pentahydrate to 100 cm cube with distilled water in a standard measuring flask and shake well. Then pipette out 10 cm cube of the diluted solution in a 100 cm cube beaker. Add liquor ammonia solution drop wise till the dark blue colored cupra ammonium complex forms. Then decompose the complex with glacial acetic acid and add one or two drops more. That glacial acetic acid may increase the solubility of copper sulfate solution in the solution. Then add 20 cm cube of 10% Ki solution to it and stir well. Insert a platinum electrode and connect it to the positive terminal of the potentiometer. Take saturated KCl solution in another beaker. After cleaning and rinsing it, place a saturated calomel electrode in a KCl solution and connect it to the negative terminal of the potentiometer. Insert a KCl salt bridge connecting the two beakers. Then meanwhile add 0.5 cm cube of sodium thiosulfate solution from the burette in the beaker containing copper sulfate solution along with liquor ammonia, acetic acid and 10% Ki solution. And measure the reading, that is EMF, from the potentiometer. The cell representation for the experiment is saturated calomel electrode, which is a standard reference electrode where the 100% charge is stabilized, that is sharing of electron is 100%, that if the electrode gives or donates its electron, then it will occupy itself also. This double line indicating presence of salt bridge, which can generate liquid junction potential. Then this iodine platinum electrode is inserted in a iodine solution that may are recorded in the EMF column via inserting or adding 0.5 cm of titrant each time. The difference in EMF can be calculated in the form of delta E. Also, the difference in volume can also be calculated in the form of delta V. There is delta E divided by delta V will give this table. In the last section, we have observed sharp increase in the equivalence point, that is, we are getting here equivalence point. In that same manner, we will carry out 2 or 5 readings further. Let's plot a graph of volume of titrant added versus EMF, which is a graph A. Will get a sigmoid curve, and the equivalence point obtained can be measured as Vx1, that is unknown volume 1, which is 8.5 cm³. In the second plot, there is a graph of volume of titrant added versus delta E divided by delta V, which is in millivolt per cm³. Here we are getting bell shaped plot, and the equivalence point obtained from this plot is measured as Vx2, which is observed at 8.7 cm³. The reaction involving in the experiment is the copper sulfate first reacts with copper potassium iodide, and that may liberate 2 equivalent of copper sulfate liberate 2 equivalent of molecular iodine, which in turn oxidizes 2 equivalents of sodium thiosulfate. Copper sulfate solution cannot be directly titrated with sodium thiosulfate solution, as there is no direct reaction between copper plus 2 ions and sodium thiosulfate reductant. Let's proceed towards calculation part. First, we'll determine volume of sodium thiosulfate solution required for the equivalence point. From graph of EMF against volume of titrant added, we are obtained first equivalence point that is mentioned as Vx1, which is 8.5 cm³. From the another graph, volume of titrant added against delta E divided by delta V will provide a second equivalence point, that is Vx2, which is 8.7 cm³. Therefore, the mean volume is equals to Vx1 plus Vx2 divided by 2, which is equals to 8.6 cm³. Secondly, we have to find out the amount of copper sulfate pentahydrate solution. From this, we are going to estimate amount of copper present in a given solution. Here is reactions. Two equivalents of sodium thiosulfate equivalents with two equivalents of iodide ion, which is equivalent to two copper ions and which is equivalent to the 2 moles of copper sulfate pentahydrate solution. Therefore, the ratio is 1:1. Hence, 10 cm³ of the diluted solution required Vx, that is 8.6 cm³ of 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Therefore, 100 cm³ of the diluted solution require 10 into Vx, that is 10 into 8.6 cm³ of 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate solution. Now, 1000 cm³ of 1 normal sodium thiosulfate solution is equals to 63.54 gram of copper, which is the molecular weight of copper or atomic weight of copper, which is equals to 249.54 gram of copper sulfate pentahydrate solution. Hence, amount of copper present in a solution can be determined by cross multiplying, that is 10 into Vx, that is 10 into 8.6 cm³ of 0.05 normal sodium thiosulfate solution gives 63.54 into 249.54 into 10 into 8.6 divided by 1000 cm³. The calculated amount of copper is 0.273 gram of copper present in a unknown or given solution. The result is volume of sodium thiosulfate required for the titration of 10 cm³ of the diluted copper solution is 8.6 cm³. Amount of copper present in a given solution is equals to 0.273 gram. Thank you.